The next person we have is Julian. Julian from Yellow Brick.
Hello, my name is Julian. I work for two companies, one called Yellow Brick, without the W, and one called Hoffi. And until 5 years ago, I'd probably describe myself as a designer. And for the last 5 years, I've kind of been making art as well. So I'd probably make myself a maker if I was going to describe myself in some way. And I'm going to talk to you today about some of our work that we've done over the last 5 years, and then kind of respond to the zombie analogy afterwards. So the Yellow Brick started with the idea of community engagement, fundamentally at its core, and a bit like Slingshot and 2.8 hours later, they originally did a games festival. And we start with a games festival called Play Arc. So this is street games, pervasive street games, theater pieces, promenade pieces, that kind of stuff. The idea behind it was just that you had to be playful. And I think Verity will probably speak a bit about that later. But how we differ as a company with Yellow Brick is that we would describe ourselves as a marketing company fundamentally. So we're a marketing company that sells our skills to businesses and brands. So this here is a piece of work for Welsh National Opera, which was to go pre-content for their Tudor season of operas. You took an online test with a lady that responded to you on video. So if you typed in you were 30 years old, she'd respond to that and go, looking a bit crabby for that age. You possibly would tell her a secret. She would ring you up on your mobile phone and tell you her secret. The idea being that at the end of this, you either entered the Tudor court or you got executed. And then that execution photo was then posted on Facebook and all social media. And there was a red stripe across the neck. So this is our kind of marketing angle, but what it allows us to do is make stuff for ourselves. So these two pieces, one funded totally by ourselves, this one funded by ourselves and Arts Council, Wales Art Council money, are multi-platform interactive pieces that have pre-content. So we meet characters on blogs, Twitter, through his notebook, through audio stories, emails, text messages with the audience. This then comes into a similar thing to 2.8, but smaller numbers. And then it continues into the next section. So this is part of a trilogy, and the trilogy will end next year. That's basically how we look at it. And what we're finding within the stuff that we're doing is there's becoming a bigger blur between marketing and production. We're not defining it as one or the other. So this stuff here all has benefit for our marketing to sell tickets for this. So this stuff is all free, and it drives people to this. So this is where we make our money. This is where we get our enjoyment from, though, because this is where we tag people. This is where we ring them up. This is where we immerse them. So I'm going to just kind of list four things that I think the arts could learn from zombies. One is, as James said earlier, if you think of zombies, you instantly know the rules, you instantly know the world, and you understand the world that exists. So if you're going to a piece and you don't really understand it, build a world. It's kind of questioning how we work as people within the arts. This is, I guess, a traditional structure for theatre. So you probably get an idea, get some funding, do some R&D, do nothing, and then you'll kick in later on because everyone's waiting for the money to come in. This is how we work. We get the funding, get the R&D, and work forever. It's tiring, but it does have benefits because what you're looking at is world building, and you're understanding what consequences and decisions people would make. Equally, I don't think it's enough just to make stuff just for yourself. I think you've got to think about the audience. This is a graph of tablets, mobile devices, and desktop usage during the day. And if you're making a 2-hour thing that's published at lunchtime, then no one's going to view it. They've not got the time. Equally, if you make it on tablet or mobile, no one's going to view it because they're on the desktop. So have an idea of where people are, what they're doing, and kind of interact with their lives. Also, try and make people say, I did, rather than I saw. Get them involved. I think that's finally, one sec. Yeah. Finally, don't be scared of money or making money or talking about money. We do need money to build things. After the first time, when you kind of have had 2 months of working on something, throw up in the bathroom because you're so tired, you kind of need help. So do think of money. And if anyone wants to discuss this later, these are my details. Thank you.
Thank you, Julian.